Boats are bottoming out in Cape Coral. The drought has dried up the city canals, leaving boats like this one you can see right here high and dry behind countless homes in the city. NBC2's Jesse Pagan continues our team coverage. People are telling him they've never seen it this bad before.
Kelly, I want to start off showing off by you guys this right here. You can see the stain right here. That's obviously where the water used to be. Obviously, it's gone down now, causing this boat bottomed out on this canal. Now it's just sitting on the sand.
It's just going on the sand. It's just kind of went down slow and it's just settled.
Paradise is drying up for Ron Brandage.
We've got 7 lakes that we can go to from here, but right now we're not going anywhere. We're sitting right here.
Quite literally, Cape Coral's drought is severe enough, it's grounded Ron's boat right behind his home. It's been like this for about a month.
Well, there's nothing we can do. I mean, to get it on the water is one thing, but then to get it back to the dock is another, so.
His neighbor Lee has been watching it all unfold from her backyard across the canal, an archipelago to her.
Look over there, I got an island. You can clean it off and put a picnic bench on it. Look at that, I got an island over there. It's not supposed to be.
It's been about a week and a half since the city began pumping water from a mine in Charlotte County, 17 million gallons a day. The city explains it could take 10 days for some spots to see relief, which both Ron and Lee hope flows in soon.
We've never seen it like this before. Yeah. And I hope there's a solution soon, whether it be man-made or God-made with the rain. We don't have to experience this again.
Ron says his boat here needs about 40 inches of water to come back to its normal height. That way he can actually get back out on the water and go where he needs to go. Of course, he and a lot of other neighbors around here hoping for a lot more rain. In Cape Coral, Jesse Pagan, NBC2.